Hello, my name is Owen Galt. I work as a consultant paediatrician at University Hospitals of Morecambe Bay, part of the Better Care Together group. This video is about diarrhoea and vomiting in children, otherwise known as gastroenteritis. And I'll take you through what that is and also the sort of things you can do to help so that your child doesn't need to come to hospital. So what is gastroenteritis? It's normally caused by a virus, and the commonest virus that causes it is called rotavirus. It's a common infection, particularly in children less than 5 years of age, and most children around that time will get at least one episode of gastroenteritis per year. Unfortunately, it's easily transmitted, particularly through contaminated food or in just contaminated surfaces in the environment, so it's very important that hand washing is a priority. One of the symptoms of gastroenteritis, obviously vomiting and diarrhea, are the two main symptoms. Some children also have a temperature. Unfortunately, young children tend to be the worst affected as they haven't really developed an immunity to all infections yet. Most children, though, if they have a mild infection, particularly older children, can normally carry on as normal. Don't worry too much, allow them to feed normally, drink plenty, and certainly in young babies, continue breastfeeding. When might you need to seek some advice? Well, some children will have either dry nappies or they'll be producing less urine than normal. They may appear tired, and in babies, you'll notice that perhaps their soft spot on the top of the head is sunken. Particularly seek advice if you've developed symptoms of diarrhea and vomiting after a recent foreign holiday, as that might be caused by a different bug to normal. If you do have any concerns, you can speak to your general practitioner or family doctor, nurse practitioner, health visitor, or school nurse. Now, there are some symptoms that we do particularly worry about, so I'll just describe some of those. Seek more urgent help if your child is less than 3 months of age and has a temperature more than 38 degrees, or if your child is more than 3 months of age and has a temperature of greater than 39 degrees. Seek help if they're short of breath, or if their hands and feet are cold, or if they appear confused or drowsy. Specific gastrointestinal symptoms or tummy symptoms that might indicate a particular problem are vomiting bright green vomit, otherwise known as bile. It looks the same sort of colour as a washing up liquid. If they're vomiting for more than 3 days or have diarrhoea for more than a week, then it's probably worthwhile seeking some advice from a medical practitioner. Seek urgent advice if they have a distended tummy or if they have severe abdominal pain or if there's any blood or mucus, looks like slime in their poo. Now, for most children, the illness is relatively mild and you should be able to manage at home. In particular, give them lots of fluids to drink, and normally giving small amounts of fluid often is the best, so it reduces the chance of vomiting. If you can, get hold of some. Use oral rehydration sachets or solution. This is a powder that you mix into water and it contains salt and sugar, and that helps the water be absorbed by the gut. If not, use sugary cordial or iced lollies as a replacement for the fluid. Try and avoid fruit juice or fizzy drinks because that can make diarrhea and vomiting worse. Now, most children who come to us at the hospital don't actually have anything special or specific done other than the things that I've already described that you can do at home. Most children just have some observation. We give them small amounts of fluid often, typically using that oral rehydration solution that I've mentioned. And very few children need any specific tests or any intravenous fluids as a drip. So hopefully most children can be managed at home. But once your child is on the mend, offer them drinks regularly and small amounts of food, again, little and often. Toast is particularly good, or something simple. Now, unfortunately, children do remain infectious for several days even after their symptoms have settled. It's important that your child doesn't return to a childcare facility, nursery or school for at least 48 hours after their symptoms have settled. And they shouldn't swim in a public pool for at least 2 weeks afterwards. And that's it. I hope the information I've provided has been useful. In most cases, we do exactly the same things at the hospital as you can do at home, where your child is most comfortable and where they're most familiar with their surroundings. Please do note some of those more significant symptoms that I've mentioned. If any of those are present, seek help from a medical practitioner. Otherwise, most children get better in time on their own. Thank you.